Hello, love. Welcome home to Eden. So here we are on the bridge of flowers, and it's time to create a new reality. So everybody, please get out and vote tomorrow. You know, a lot of elections are going to be determined by these elections tomorrow. So just do a little research online. I really liked Francia. There's a lot of good candidates now. But you know, my biggest feeling that we all really need to start looking into is women in politics. Let's get more women in there, because I'm just seeing, like, over time, it's not that there aren't some radical, loving men, but there are so many men in there who do what they do at the job force. They treat politics like they treat their other jobs, which is about my power and my boys' club and doing favors for my other boys. And, you know, am I going to be protected for my money? The women, all the women I know, when I see them in politics all around the world, it's very consistent that war and bombs is very, very small. It's not that they don't want protection, but it is a different kind of priority system what women have. We just want to take care of what is here in this world, in this life that we have here. That means the education of our children. That means the health of our bodies, everybody getting health coverage without having to earn it, earn the right to just be healthy. You know, the women, we are in touch with here and now. Our agenda is often selfless. It really is. It's often just like, hey, let's make sure people have jobs where they actually can be paid. Did you know that there is 2/3 of the American population are living, whole families are living under $22,000 a year? Can you imagine? That is like substandard, of almost unable to buy anything or even make your own, you know, cover your own needs. That's 2/3 of the American population. So the priorities of our country have got to turn upside down. And who better to do that than the women? Because our priorities already are upside down of what men find important in general. So these men, you guys have been doing this for a long time. You've been in there, you've had the power, and you keep voting for yourself, basically. What's in it for me? Like the women in Sweden say, they say categorically, the men are thinking, what's in it for me, rather than what's in it for my community? What's in it for our children? What's in it for the future? What's in it for the planet? You know, and that's the other thing, is not being afraid of climate change, like facing it. I'm on the doors doing my solar work all the time. And over again, the women are open to facing the problem, doing something about it now. And the men are like, well, what's in it for me? Am I going to save enough money? Am I going to get the best panels? Am I going to get the best deal? You know, right now, we don't have enough time to keep thinking, what's in it for me in terms of saving the planet? I want the best panels. It doesn't matter. All the panels, solar panels, are the same, basically. It doesn't matter, because what matters is our future and our present becoming a joyous reality. So people are like, oh, you know, nothing's ever going to change. This is the negative, cynical attitude that men keep coming at me with when I say, let's save the planet, let's get solar, let's get women in their politics. They're like, women will be just the same as men. That cynicism is the key to why things don't change, because as long as you're cynical, you get to use that as your excuse not to put in the effort, not to make a difference yourself, not to allow women to have the power and support they need to do the work they're willing to do. You know, us women, it's when we work for our families and our communities, we are not feeling exhausted by it. We're grateful for the opportunity to use our power wisely. And if we're grateful for that, then just allow us to do what we're here to do. We're life givers. So please vote for the women in going up for election right now, as long as they stand for the things that you stand for, or the planet and the earth and the children and the education and the saving the planet and the climate change, and la 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 la. All right. So here I am. Here's my little rant. And guys, get with it. Like, you got enough bombs. You have enough outfits. I saw this police officer at the food stamp office the other day, and there he was, bored out of his mind, standing there hour after hour. Wow, it looked like one of the hardest jobs I've ever seen a guy have to do. You know, because really, people don't need policing all day. We don't. That's not what we need. We need the arts. We need music. We need more dancing. We need more parties. But we really need money in people's pockets so that they can have that fun, create those parties. Beautiful. Thank you for being with me on the Bridge of Flowers, the bridge. I'm taking this walk across the river of destiny here to a new reality. And when I get to the other side of this bridge, we are going to have women in politics. Do you know there's more than 27,000 women running now? Women have woken up with the baby Tweety Bird on the throne in his diapers, just trying desperately to grab his power at all costs. And the women are like, oh my God, we let this happen. We believed in men so much that we didn't speak up to our own men right beside us and say, look, honey, actually, I do believe that we can do something to help climate change. I believe it. And I believe that solar panels, and I sound like I'm selling solar because I do sell solar, but I'm not trying to sell it to you. I'm trying to sell to you the idea of, you know, doing something for climate action, you know. But think about it, the satellite up in the sky, our space station, what do you think runs that? People, you think there's a hose up there for electricity or is it running on gas? No, it's solar. It's solar is running our space station. It's been up there since the 70s. That's how reliable and cheap and efficient solar energy is. Okay, so that's good. Got that settled. So here we come towards the end of the bridge. Tell me, please, promise me, you will listen to the women around you. If you're a woman, you will start feeling your power. You will start believing in your own ability to speak up and just take it. If people insult you and they don't be afraid of that. Just assume that's part of speaking up, is that people belittle you and they just try to disenfranchise me. Like a lot of times they'll try to say, dismissal. And acting like, well, I know way better than you. How dare you speak? You know what? The intuitive heart knows that taking care of your body is a good idea, that eating good food and having organic food is a good idea, that having health care for everyone is a necessity, that oh my gosh, you know, that our children need to be able to go to college and start their lives and enjoy their lives without having to be in debt for the rest of, punished for having gone to school for the rest of their lives by their debt. No. This is a new day, and guess what? All over the world, they are already, in all these other countries, they're living with 100% coverage for their health care. They are living with free college for their kids. This movie, Where to Invade Next, by Michael Moore, is a really great one to see because he actually goes there to all of these countries, and he shows you firsthand their jail systems are not even jails, they're reform, they're places for rehab. The whole idea with drugs is just about, okay, some people really need to have rehab, and some people are that way, and just by minimizing it in certain countries, their drug problem has dropped. Instead of putting everybody in jail for that, it's treated like, you know, kind of like a psychopathic illness that has to be, after a while, healed. And so, here we are. We've made it to the other side of the bridge, okay? The other side of the Bridge of Flowers. And here we are. This land is the land of the goddess. This is Eve's Eden, where women are not afraid of their power anymore. And women are open, outspoken, and feeling loved and lovable by their men by being powerful. This is where the men listen to the women. This is where the men love the women being in power. They do. This is where the water is flowing. The waters of life are knowing, because we're giving to life. Our priority is life. Our priority is love. Our priority is children. Our priority is racial integration, and truly in our hearts, seeing how all people of all nations all over the planet have the exact same needs for peace, abundance, health, protection, education, freedom of speech, welcoming of immigrants in need as the climate demands people be embraced. Yes, thank you so much for hearing my agenda and having the humility and the openness and the willingness to share this. Okay, share this message and vote tomorrow. Vote tomorrow, okay? September 4th. Get out there. Do it. Vote for the women and the agenda of the feminine heart within the men. Okay, love to you, darling. Love life and subscribe to this channel.